Okay, so right now we're gonna talk about your techniques. When I saw your videos, whether it's in Instagram, Facebook, or YouTube, you have this like very unique take on chord progression. Like you can like.
Okay.
Yeah. Show me.
Okay, so I mean, like, this is very based after working with Tori Kelly.
Okay.
You know, she does all those runs, the vocal runs, and
okay.
You know, and, you know, like that type of thing. And I don't know, I'm just
gonna stuck with this. Okay.
And it's a combination of a double stops and
double stops,
I don't know how to call it. Like, what's the name of this? Like, it's like hammer on.
I think it's called the angelic slide.
Okay.
The angelic
slide.
You should name it.
As you said. Okay.
Yeah, you made it look like 100 times easier.
Ah, man. Work on that. It's as you can see, it's not like a whole half. It's a barely feel. You know, it's just. Yeah, so it's something about like the touch. So the touch is the most important. Yeah, exactly. It's more like a sounding flavor. So. So just imagine like a harmonization of the D major interval, right? So. So, I would recommend you to use the finger, this finger.
This finger?
Oh, this
one.
Okay. No, this one. This,
oh, this one.
Okay. And this. All right, yeah, cool. And the middle. So, for this first position. And that's just like more like a sounding flavor thing, you know? And the whammy is very helpful too. Like sometimes I wanna. So, you know,
you should feel guilty about showing me those.
I mean, I'm sorry because I really wanted to explain this better, but sometimes it's kind of hard for me.
But the
long story short is I combine some type of intervals,
okay,
and then I add this little movements. Can you do this? So D major in the C shape. Yeah. got it. So just imagine that that's also, I got this from one of the classes at MI called Jimi Hendrix Experience.
Jimi Hendrix Experience?
Oh, Jimi Hendrix Rhythm Guitar, I'm sorry, not Experience. Okay. And so it was like we grabbed a random major chord progression and then we just keep the same, yeah, the same feel.
Okay.
Just, but changing with the chord, so. And A. That's also another tip
of
how I
guitar.
Work on this like rhythm and feel kind of thing.
Do you have any tips for the like more beginner player to how they should start of learning that? What's your practice, like the basic practice of your guitar playing, like, well, in the, back in the days?
Okay, I think everything is based on the caged system.
Cage system.
So the caged system totally changed my way of thinking, of analyzing the neck. So, because I back in the days before MI, I was just about the regular pentatonic shape. So everything was based on this.
Yeah.
Only.
Okay. Yeah.
And then when I learned about the cage system, I could finally identify all the notes of the neck.
Okay.
And with that, okay, I came up. I mean, we it opens up for the chords, inversions, right?
Yeah.
So that kind of gave me a different perspective of like chords, scales, not only in this way, the vertical, regular way of, but more. So instead of just going this way, go more like this way, you know? You know, and
I'm just gonna stick with it.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. I know. That's all for the technique, and thank you so much.
Thank you.